New comic book day is upon us again, so let's take a look at the books on my pull list. Welcome back to Comics Are Dope. I'm BJ Kicks, and this is The Pull List. It's my weekly video series where I take a look at the books coming out this Wednesday. This time we're looking at Wednesday, April 17th, 2024. I'm going to tell you which books are on my pull list, what's on the chopping block, and some other books that maybe, perhaps, should be on your radar as well. I always like to start these off with the book that I am most excited about. But first, a couple items of business. First, rest in peace to the legendary Rico Wade, founder of the Dungeon family, the reason that any of us knows that Outcast exists. Also, the reason I'm wearing an Outcast shirt today. But yeah, he passed. He was only like 52, which is crazy because he appeared to be in good health, but you never know. But anyway, to all of his family, friends, fans, you know, my condolences. And man, a legend. That dude made waterfalls like Aquemini is like my favorite Outkast album, one of my favorite albums, period. Like, I've played that album so much, but that dude made waterfalls anyway. So there's that. Also, I want to give a quick shout out to my man, Will Robson. Will Robson is an artist and writer of comics. You may have seen him with work on Spawn, from Marvel. He did Spider-Man and Deadpool. That's the one I kept wanting to say, Spider-Man and Wolverine, different book. But anyway, Spider-Man and Deadpool, Great Lakes Avengers, a bunch of different cool things Will Robson has worked on in the past. But now he's got a brand new Kickstarter project that just launched today. So he's got an anthology series called Outbreaks, and Outbreaks is an anthology series about zombies. Now, issues 1 and 2 have already been Kickstarted. They're out there. You can read them online. Well, some of it you can read online. But he just launched today a Kickstarter for issue number 3. You can get issues 1, 2, and 3. They're really cool, like Todd McFarlane homage variant covers. There is a cover by The Walking Dead co-creator Tony Moore for issue number 3. A lot of really cool perks. I actually spoke with Will about this on Friday. You guys will hear that conversation probably later this week, but I wanted to shout it out today because on day one, there are some exclusives that you can get only if you back on day one, including a signed version of the Tony Moore art print for the cover for issue number 3. So really, really cool stuff in the works there. I read issues 1 and 2 of the Outbreaks anthology. I love it. Like, it's not just your traditional zombie story. It's like all types of stories set in this universe where there is a zombie outbreak. Really, really cool stuff. But anyway, we can talk about Outbreaks on the Outbreaks episode. Just wanted to let you know the link to the Kickstarter is in the description down below, just in case you wanted to be one of those day one backers and not miss out on the special bookmark or the trading cards or any of the other bonuses for backing on day one. Now, let's get to the book that I am most excited to read in this week's upcoming slate of releases. It's another heavy week for me, but man, there's nothing that's going to be on the pile above Ultimate Black Panther, issue number 3, written by Brian Edward Hill with art by Stefano Caselli. This book has been amazing. Brian Edward Hill is finally writing Black Panther. And yes, it's Ultimate Universe Black Panther, so there are some things that are going to sort of subvert your expectations. But out of all of the Ultimate Universe stuff, this is the book that feels the most familiar. Like, this feels like the T'Challa we know and love, but there are some key differences that you'll see between this and like the 616 universe, especially the deeper you get into it. There was a really cool reveal at the end of issue 2, and now in issue 3 we're going to get Storm and Killmonger making their official debuts in the series as opposed to the cameo we got in issue 1. And I, for one, am excited to see it. Like, man, Brian Edward Hill is writing Black Panther. It's got an amazing artist. The story is great so far. The only thing that would make this experience better for me is if my bro Skip was here to read it and discuss it with me. Like, he wanted Brian Edward Hill on a Black Panther book so bad. And now it's here and we can't even talk about it. But Ultimate Black Panther, issue number 3, absolutely the most exciting book on my to read pile this week. Grabbing issue 3 with a cover price of $4.99. And I'm grabbing cover A. Just to let you know, they've been doing second and third printings of issues 1 and 2. There is a second printing of issue 2 coming out today. And I already have issue 2, but that Mateus Manhanini cover for the second printing, in my opinion, might beat the A cover for the first printing. And I just love that cover. So I might end up buying that too. But anyway, I think that will be $5.99 because it's a series debut. If you get in that second print, no matter what you do, stay current on Ultimate Black Panther. The entire Ultimate Universe is amazing right now through 2 and 3 issues of each series. So Ultimate Black Panther, issue 3, $4.99. Grab cover A. Now, let's keep things going with the rest of the books on the Marvel pull list. Making a return to the pull list is Avengers Twilight, issue number 5. Issue 5 of Avengers Twilight is out this week. I don't remember if this is a 5 or 6 issue mini. But this has been a really fast-paced sort of Dark Knight Returns style story told through the lens of Captain America specifically, but with several of the Avengers. We've seen Kamala Khan. We've seen Thor make an appearance. So we've got a lot of really cool stuff, and there is a sort of Iron Man figure that we're looking at. There's some interesting stuff going on. We had the one villain that we thought was the villain. Now we're learning that it's a little bit more intricate than that. And I'm having a lot of fun with this, like I said. But can't lie, it's been a little bit of time since issue 4. Like, I feel like this book was coming out like every 2 weeks, and then all of a sudden it stopped for a minute. But hey, now we're back with Avengers Twilight. Issue number 5 should be a great issue. And by the way, they are really leaning into this whole Dark Knight Returns comparison. There's been a lightning bolt variant for every issue featuring a different member of the Avengers, posed in front of a lightning bolt like that iconic Dark Knight Returns cover. So I don't know. That might be one of the picks if you're going to grab this issue, because I can't lie, this cover A might be the weakest of the Alex Ross covers. But as far as I understand, they are connecting covers. So I'm going to stick with cover A for a price of $4.99. Next up on the Marvel Comics pull list, you guys will be so proud of me, by the way. I spent like all weekend, instead of recording more videos, I just sat and read comics. So I am 100% caught up on every book on the pull list this week. So Fall of the House of X, issue number 4. I'm finally caught up with it. And I'm like, I don't know. Something about the Fall of X era just kind of fell apart for me. It's not bad. It's wrapping up. Everything is going to its natural conclusion. It's just not particularly exciting to me. The Rise of the Powers of 10 definitely feels like the book with the most stakes or the highest stakes. But even some of that is like, what is happening right now? All in all, as you can see, I'm still down for both. Issue 4 out this week. Cyclops has an unlikely ally, and it's time for the humans and the machines and the mutants to all fight. And let's guess who's going to win for the sake of posterity. Anyway, Fall of the House of X, number 4, out this week. Cover price is $4.99. I'm grabbing cover A. Next up on the pull list is Miles Morales' Spider-Man, issue number 19. Now, Miles Morales' Spider-Man by Cody Ziegler, still one of my favorite books, especially when the art is done by Federico Vincentini. Now, issue 18 was actually like an oversized spectacular because it was issue 300 in legacy numbering. And man, I keep telling you guys this, but I'm going to say it again, right? When Cody Ziegler is not having to tie in to some random event or other happenings in the Marvel Universe, he is just writing the book of his life with Miles Morales. Like, he's giving Miles basically his own Sinister Six, like slash Suicide Squad. Like, this Miles versus Rabble thing just keeps getting, like, the stakes keep getting higher and higher. Like, it's dope. It's dope. I really hope he gets to write the 30 plus issues that he says that he wants to write on this book. I think he's going to get it. We're already 18 issues in, but man, this book just keeps getting better. Now, I want to say this is the last issue before we have to tie in with like some Blood Hunt stuff, but hey, I'm down for it. Cody Ziegler keeps making it interesting. The art still looks great, and the story has been amazing. So Miles Morales, Spider-Man issue 19 out this week with a cover price of $3.99. I'm grabbing cover A. And the last book on the Marvel Comics pull list this week, speaking of Miles Morales, is Spectacular Spider-Man issue number 2. This coming from Greg Weisman with art by Umberto Ramos. And this book, I feel like issue 1 was kind of shaky for me. There were some moments where like the dialogue was just a little bit too much. And then we had like some really weird, like sort of cut scenes, like, I don't know, stuff that felt like it would work really well in animation, but not so much in a comic book. All that to say, I still like the premise. Peter and Miles trying to sort of rekindle their relationship just after Peter was gone for 6 months in real time. And also, like, you know, have this sort of mentor-mentee relationship that they've never really had in comics. And they're trying to do it low-key. They're trying to give us like a slice of life book. But this is a Marvel superhero comic, so of course, superhero action has to come with it. So I like the premise. I like the dialogue for the most part. But there are just some things that aren't quite working with me that I think perhaps will get better over time. Maybe the jokes will land better with more context. I don't know. But I wasn't ready to like sour on it completely after issue 1. So issue 2 of Spectacular Spider-Man is out this week with a cover price of $3.99. I'm grabbing cover A. And that's it for the Marvel Comics on the pull list. As long as I stick to the list, those will cost me $23 this week. Another heavy Marvel week. Go figure. Let's go ahead and take a look at the distinguished competition and see what's going on at DC Comics, where the first book on the pull list is Green Lantern War Journal, issue number 8. Green Lantern War Journal, written by Philip Kennedy Johnson with art by Montos. Now, we've had this whole storyline going for the entirety of the series of John Stewart versus the forces of the Revenant Queen. And he's not quite in the clear just yet, but it appears that one thing that is happening is he's starting to face the ramifications of using his powers to appease his mother, who is suffering from dementia or Alzheimer's or something of the sort. And it's interesting kind of seeing how he's balancing doing all this off-world stuff and trying to save the world in a different dimension while he's also trying to manage the crisis at home. And there are some interesting people showing up as allies in this process as well. This has been a really good book. I'm not going to lie. This has gotten a little bit sci-fi heavy for me, right? Like, which, I mean, I guess that's what a Green Lantern book is, but just all the space stuff, it's a little over cosmic for me at points. But the stuff with John's mother really keeps it grounded in a way that allows me to stay and occupy that space, even when I don't necessarily fully understand what's happening everywhere else. Also, some stuff coming back from the Warworld saga. So if you read Superman's Warworld and you were missing Philip Kennedy Johnson, all that stuff isn't lost. He's still doing some of that stuff right here. So all the more reason to buy this book. Philip Kennedy Johnson and Montos on Green Lantern War Journal continues with issue 8. Cover price on this one is $3.99. I'm grabbing cover A. And next book on the pull list this week is a book that I am so excited to have finally caught up on. This is Nightwing issue 113. Now, there's been a lot going on with Nightwing. I feel like it started off really, really strong when Tom Taylor and Bruno Redondo took over at issue 78. Started really, really strong as like I feel like you could have called this volume better than Batman and we would have believed it, as opposed to the Rebirth era back in the day. But this was showing like how good a job Bruce and Alfred did with raising Nightwing. So we started off with showing Alfred's influence in Nightwing's life, and we got the introduction of a new villain. Right. And then we've got a bunch of different seemingly one-off adventures, but they do all kind of come together. They all lead to where we are now. But right now in this series, what I'm enjoying is that this is like showing us also how Batman was a really good influence. Now, what I will say is I feel like Batman is being written a little bit less Batman-y. Like, I feel like Tom Taylor was putting a few too many words in Batman's mouth, a few too many kind sentiments in Batman's mouth. On one hand, I really appreciate it. I appreciate him showing how great a father Bruce is. But I feel like there are some things being said in costume that just wouldn't normally be said. But I kind of let it slide because I appreciate the sentiments. So there's that. All in all, I think this book definitely lost a little bit of steam toward the middle of the run, but it's always been enjoyable. I think the best part has been the relationship between Dick Grayson and Barbara Gordon. And even that's got some interesting things coming out of it right now in the storyline. The one thing I have not read is Tom Taylor's Titans run, nor have I read Beast World. But everything in Nightwing has still been going well, and I don't feel like I've missed out on anything by not reading Beast World, although I do plan to read Beast World. All that to say, I think the Nightwing by Tom Taylor is going to make a great omnibus. I do feel like out of all the charm that this series has, it's not moving enough with the main villain, but it seems like we're setting up for the main villain to return for the big finale, which does start in a 5-issue arc with issue 114. So for now, issue 113, maybe we're going to find out why Nightwing can't jump or not. We'll see. Cover price on this one is, oh, before I say that, this one is also a legacy number. This is a legacy number 300 as well. So it's going to be a nice oversized issue. Cool. That's great. The draw for this oversized issue is that Marv Wolfman is returning to tell a Nightwing story. So if you wanted a reason to buy this book, this should be a nice sort of one shot to read in the middle of this run before you go to the finale arc that's starting next month. Anyway, that's all I had to say about Nightwing issue 113, out this week with a cover price of just $4.99. And cover A is cool. It's cool, but I feel like we've seen the Nightwing running across multiple floors thing a lot in this run. What I love, the cover I love for this issue specifically, is the Dan Mora variant with Robin running up ahead and Nightwing in the background. That's the cover to buy. If you're going to spend an extra dollar, buy that one. Even above the Jim Lee COVID sketch variant, even above that one, buy the Dan Mora cover. I'm going to buy the Dan Mora cover. $4.99. There we go. Next up on the pull list is Superman, issue number 13. Superman written by Josh Williamson. This one's got art by Rafa Sandoval. This is the second part in the House of Braniac crossover. I guess we're not calling it an event technically because it doesn't really involve the rest of the DC universe. I don't know how that works anymore. But this, basically, if you hadn't been keeping up with Superman, you could have jumped right in with Action Comics last week. I love when the crossovers hit right after each other or back to back weeks. Makes it so much easier to keep up with the story. But basically, there's been an invasion of Zarnians, and we find out that perhaps Lobo isn't involved, and perhaps Lobo is going to be upset when he finds out what's going on. But also Brainiac is involved. So we got Brainiac orchestrating this return of the Zarnians, and they are just wreaking all types of havoc. And it's time for Superman and Lex to get to the bottom of it. Really enjoying it so far. If you've been reading Josh Williamson's Superman, this is what it's been leading to. Like, you're going to love it. If you were not reading Josh Williamson's Superman and you were only reading Action Comics and this is your reason for buying Superman 13, I would encourage you to go back and read the rest of the Superman run. It's not essential. Like, everything you need to know is there, but I think the story pays off a lot better if you read what came led up to it. Anyway, Superman 13 out this week with a cover price of $4.99. I'm grabbing cover A, and let's move on to the last book on the DC Comics pull list this week. That is Wonder Woman issue number 8 from Tom King and Daniel Samper. Finally getting back on track. We had a sort of fill-in issue for issue 7. It was Superman and Wonder Woman in a space mall trying to get Batman a gift. Was it his birthday? Why were they getting him a gift? I assume it was his birthday. I don't remember though. Anyway, point is, it was kind of a throwaway issue, but I did find it charming. But I'm ready to get back to the main event, the main story, this, the Wonder Woman versus the Sovereign. And that is what we're exactly what we're getting to with issue number 8 of Wonder Woman. This has probably my favorite art in a comic right now. It's between this and Green Lantern. Windsor Monaco is on the art. Also, Federico Vincentino Miles. There are a lot of books with great art out right now, but this is among the favorites for me. Cover price on this one is $4.99. I'm grabbing cover A. So that's it for the DC comics on the pull list. As long as I stick to the list, those are going to cost me $19 this week. Not terrible. So 23 and 19. What's that? 42 going into the indies. We're not in a bad spot. We're not in a bad spot, but let's skip on over to the indies where first book on the pull list is one that's been delayed a little bit. This is Darkwing Duck Justice Ducks issue number 2, written by Roger Langridge with art by Carlo Cid Lauro. Carlo Lauro did art on the original Darkwing series from Dynamite last year. So if you liked that, you'll like this. The story is basically like alien invasion. I feel like the way the Justice Ducks solved it in the first issue was just the most ridiculous thing, but that's kind of what Darkwing is known for, is ridiculous things. I enjoyed it, so it should be fun this time around as well. As far as I know, the stories are fairly self-contained, but they do have the through line of them being the alien invasion. If you want to know more about this series, then check out my interview that I did with Roger Langridge on Justice Ducks on the Comics Are Dope podcast. I think you'll really like it. But anyway, Justice Ducks issue number 2 should have came out in February. It's coming out now. Cover price on it is $3.99. I'm grabbing cover A. Next up, another book that should have been out long ago, but it's coming out now. This is Moon Man issue number 2. Moon Man, written by Kid Cudi with Kyle Higgins. Or is it Kyle Higgins with Kid Cudi? I don't know. The art on it, I didn't write down the artist. Okay, the art is by Marco Licati, who I hadn't heard of prior to this series. I liked it. It's like a very sort of sketchy style that we get from him, like almost abstract in a way, but I liked it. I thought it was cool. But basically, Kid Cudi's character, this is very much Kid Cudi's guy, Ramon, which I believe is Kid Cudi's middle name, but Ramon was like basically a NASA astronaut, except it wasn't NASA. It was like some private corporation. So let's call it SpaceX. He used to work for SpaceX. There was a weird like blip, sort of cosmic accident a la Fantastic Four. He was lost for a little while. He comes back, he comes home, and he's kind of got survivor's remorse. What he's found out since coming home is that the everyday people in Cleveland have issues with the corporation that he used to work for. And so there's a lot of like sort of unrest bubbling up. Well, when his brother finds himself in the middle of that unrest, Kid Cudi's got to spring into action to save him. And as he does, he finds out he's got some superpowers. He's changed by whatever this cosmic accident was. So I'm curious to get more insight as to the nature of Cudi's powers. I got to stop calling him Cudi. His name is Ramon. The nature of Ramon's powers and how he's going to decide to use them for good, for evil, for the corporation, for the people. What are we doing here? Definitely an interesting premise so far. The art definitely is a little bit sketchy, and I liked it, but I feel like for some people it was off-putting, but I thought the story was good enough. There's a lot of different threads laid out. If you liked stuff like Radiant Black or even Power Rangers, no reason why you won't like this as well. And bonus points, I guess, if you're a Kid Cudi fan. Cover price on this one is, well, $3.99. I'm grabbing cover A. Lost my notes there for a second, but let's look at the last book on the pull list this week. And it is The Walking Dead Deluxe, issue 87. I should tell you that no, I'm not caught up on The Walking Dead Deluxe, but I did finally start reading it a couple weeks ago and I'm enjoying it. I don't feel a rush to finish The Walking Dead or, you know, to Briscoe. Like, I feel like I want to get caught up on Invincible more than I want to get caught up on The Walking Dead, but not because I don't like The Walking Dead. The Walking Dead just kind of feels like it is what it is, and I can return to it at any time. But I will say I love seeing it in color. I've been comparing the color to the black and whites online, and I like it in color. So I'm glad that they're still doing this initiative. Issue 87 out this week. Cover price is $3.99. Grabbing cover A. And that's it for the comics on my pull list this week. If I stick to the list, the indies are going to cost me $12 this week, which is not bad. But that does bring my grand total up to $54. And once again, we got to talk about, I've got to cut some things off the pull list. If I had to cut one book from this week's list, that's hard. Especially now that I'm caught up on everything, it's harder to do. I feel like Justice Ducks might be the weakest on the whole thing. Although Fall of the House of X is probably my least favorite book on this list. I've just been sticking through it because I feel so invested in the Krakoa era. So if I was being completely unbiased, I would drop Fall of the House of X. But what's most likely going to happen is I'm going to buy every single thing on the list, and I'm not going to cry about it because I'm only $4 over budget. But let's look at some stuff that should probably be on your radar, or at least piqued my interest when I was going through the new number ones for this week. So from, I think Boom Studios is publishing this. This is Blow Away, issue number one. It's written by Zach Thompson with art by Nicola Izzo. I don't know anything about that creative team, but the synopsis for this sounded really interesting. There is a photographer who is out like in the Arctic, just taking pictures like on an assignment, and apparently finds evidence of a murder. And so now is like trying to like investigate it. Apparently it's based on a movie that had a very similar title. Is it Blow Out, Blow Up, Blow Pop? I don't remember, but I didn't see the movie. The comic sounded really interesting. Zach Thompson, by the way, did like a little Q&A on League of Comic Geeks. So check that out. Anyway, Blow Away sounds like a really interesting premise for a series, sort of suspenseful thriller book. And if I had room on the pull list this week, I'd probably buy it. Cover price on it is $4.99. Next new number one this week is Gargoyle's Quest number one from Greg Weisman and Pascal Quilano. Basically, this is the continuation of Gargoyles. If you read issues 1 through 12, the Here in Manhattan storyline, then the next step is Gargoyle's Quest number one. It's a new mini series, but it's very much a continuation. Consider it Gargoyle's 13, but Demona is out for revenge all summer 16. She's trying to collect some kind of gems so she can control the world. And of course the gargoyles have to stop her. So I decided I'm going to read Gargoyles in trades as long as I didn't say anything, Siri. I decided I'm going to read Gargoyles in trades. Stop, Siri.
I'm having trouble with the connection. Please try again later.
I decided that I'm going to read Gargoyles in trades. And, you know, as long as Dynamite keeps putting out these hardcovers, I'm going to keep buying them. I liked Volume 1. It was handsome, as people say about books, for some reason. But Gargoyle's Quest, Issue 1, next chapter, $4.99. That's cover A. Next up is Dudley Datson and the Forever Machine, Issue number 1, from Scott Snyder and Jamal Eagle. Now, this was one of a part of the Comixology Originals thing that Scott Snyder did back whenever. Of course, the print license for all those books went to Dark Horse Comics. And so, this is the latest in a series of new number ones that Scott Snyder wrote long ago. Yes, you can read all of it on Comixology. Actually, no, you can't, because Comixology doesn't exist, but you still can read it on Amazon. So there's that. But I don't really know much about the series except that Jamal Eagle's drawing it and it's a black kid with a time machine, which is enough reason for me to want to buy a book. But I'm going to be disciplined and just read it on the iPad, because why am I paying all this money for Comixology if I don't? Issue number one out this week with a cover price of $4.99, and that's cover A. Those were all the new number ones that are on my radar this week and maybe will interest you. Let me know, though, in the comments down below what you're excited to grab this week. Is there anything at the big two that's like really letting you down? I gotta say, this might be the most I'm enjoying big two comics since I got into them, with the big exception of House and Powers. Like, that's House and Powers is here. Everything else I've read since then is here, maybe here. And then Immortal Hulk is like right there again. But all that to say, what are you enjoying? I do feel like Nightwing by Tom Taylor and Detective Comics by Ram V are going to make two very interesting omnibus editions, even if the story feels kind of eh at times, because Nightwing's a little bit too silly and Ram V's Detective Comics is a little bit too dark. But when you read them all together, very compelling. Each of those series, very compelling. Anyway, that's it for me this week. I'm rambling. Hope you guys enjoy your day and enjoy all your new comics. I'll see you in another video real soon. Until then, stay safe, stay awesome, and read something dope today. Peace.